Hello, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is Sikosh our interview questions and answers. So today we gonna discuss about top 20 interview questions for the beginners. So let's start with our first question. So what are the differences between DBMS and RDBMS? So first is, it stores data as a file in case of DBMS, but in case of RDBMS it stores data as a tabular form. Next is, it has unnormalized data, but in case of RDBMS it has normalized data. In DBMS it doesn't have any integrity constants, but in case of RDBMS it defines integrity constant to maintain the ACID properties. Next is, it doesn't have any relationship between the tables, but in case of RDBMS it maintains relationship between the tables by using primary key and foreign keys. Next is, it doesn't support distributed database, but in case of RDBMS it supports distributed database. Next is, it is used in small organization and it supports single user only in case of DBMS, but in RDBMS it is used in large organizations and able to handle multi users. For example, in DBMS we have file system, but in case of RDBMS we have SQL Server, Oracle, MySQL. Let's move to our next question. So what is SQL? SQL stands for Structured Query Language. So it is used to communicate with the databases. It is also used to perform tasks such as update data on the database or retrieve data from the database. Let's move to next question. So what is primary key? So primary key is a field or combination of fields in a table which uniquely identify each rows in the table. A primary key column cannot have null values. A table can't contain more than one primary keys. Let's move to another question. So our next question is, what is unique key? So unique key is a field or combination of fields in a table which uniquely identify each row in the table, as we have seen in primary key. A unique key column can have only one null value. A table can contain more than one unique keys. Let's move to next question. So what are the differences between primary key and unique key? In case of primary key, it cannot have null value, but in case of unique key it can have only one null value. Next is, a table can't have more than one primary keys, but in case of unique key a table can have more than one unique keys. By default it would create a cluster index in the table in case of primary key, but in case of unique key by default it would create a non-cluster index in the table. Move to next question. So what is foreign key? A foreign key is used to link two tables together, and foreign key is a field or combination of fields in one table that refers to the primary key in the another table. For example, let's assume we have a table with customer and it contains three columns. First is customer ID, then customer name and customer address, and we have a primary key on this table on customer ID column. And we have our second table which is sales, and it contains two columns. First is sale order and second is customer ID, and we have sale order as a primary key. And we can create a foreign key with this table which will refer in our customer table's primary key. As we can see, foreign key in our sale table, then the column name, we want to create foreign key on the customer ID column, then we need to specify a reference, then the customer table and then column. Let's move to next question. So what is check constant? The check constant is used to limit the value range that can be placed in the column. If we define a check constant on a single column, it allows only certain values for this column. Let's move to next question. So what are the joins? So joins are used to retrieve data from two or more than two related tables. Tables can be related to primary key and foreign keys. Let's move to next question. What are the types of joins in SQL Server? So mainly we have three type of joins. First is inner join, second is outer join, then cross join. In case of inner join will return only matching rows from the both tables, and a non-matching rows will be eliminated. Next is outer join. It has three type of joins. First is left outer join, second is right outer join, next is full outer join. In case of left outer join, it will return matching rows plus non-matching rows from the left table. Next is right outer join. It returns all the matching rows plus non-matching rows from the right table. Next is full outer join. It would return all the matching rows plus non-matching rows from left table plus non-matching rows from the right table. Next is cross join. It returns Cartesian product of the two tables. Those are involved in the join. Move to next question. So what are the identity column? It is also called as auto incremental column. Identity column are columns with the values automatically generated when a new row is inserted in a table. We cannot insert explicit values into identity columns. Let's move to next question. So what are the differences between delete and truncate? So delete is a DML command and truncate is a DDL command. We cannot use where condition in case of truncate, but we can use where condition in case of delete. Next, delete will be slow in terms of performance, but truncate would be faster. Next, in case of delete, it can't be reset the values for identity column, but in case of truncate, it can reset identity column values. Next, trigger will be fired in case of delete. Trigger will not be fired in case of truncate. Let's move to next question. So what are union and union all? So union operator combines result set of two or more than two select statement queries in a single result set. Union operator doesn't include duplicate rows in the final result set. Union all. Union all operator is same as a union except it includes all the unique and duplicate values in the final result set. So let's move to next question. So what are the difference between union and union all? So in case of union, it will remove the duplicate values from the result set. But in case of union all, it doesn't remove the duplicate values from the result set. Next is, in case of union, it provides sorted result set. But in case of union all, it doesn't provide any sorted result set. Next is, in case of union, it would be slower than union all. And union all would be faster than union. Let's move to next question. So what are the differences between char and varchar data types? So char, it is fixed length data type and it is used to store non-Unicode characters and it occupies 1 byte of space for each character. In case of varchar, it is variable length of data type and it is also used to store non-Unicode characters and it also occupies 1 byte of space for each character. Move to next question. So what are the differences between varchar and nvarchar data types? So in case of varchar, it is a variable length of data type and it is used to store non-Unicode characters and it occupies 1 byte of space for each character. In case of nvarchar data type, it is a variable length of data type and it is used to store Unicode characters and it occupies 2 byte of space for each character. Let's move to next question. So what are the differences between where and having clause? So in case of where, it can't be used with the aggregate functions like sum, minimum, maximum, etc. But having can be used with the aggregate functions. Where can be used with any select query, but having can be used only with the group by condition. Where clause filters rows before the aggregation. That's why it's good in performance. And having filters rows after the aggregation, that's why it's bad in performance. Let's move to next question. So what are the authentication mode in SQL Server? So first is Windows and second is mixed authentication mode. So we have two type of authentication mode in SQL Server. Let's move to next question. So what is stored procedure? Stored procedure are collection of SQL queries that can be saved and reused whenever required. And we can also pass parameters to store procedures and we can manipulate data based on the parameters. Move to next question. So what are the advantages of store procedure? So first is execution plan, retention and reusability. Next is reduced network traffic. Next is code reusability and better maintenance. Next is better security. And last is avoid SQL injection attacks. Let's move to next question. And this is our last question. So what is function? A function is a stored program that we can pass parameters or not into and return a value. For example, our first we can see getDate, it would return the current date and time without getting any parameter. But we can see our second function which is square root, it would accept a parameter, and parameter would be our numeric type. If we can pass 4 inside this sqrt, then it would return 2. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos, and don't forget to press the bell icon for getting the update of our newly uploaded videos.